Buenas tardes a todos. Voy a empezar en español para honrar a las familias. Mi nombre es Carolina Morales y estoy aquí representando a la supervisora Hillary Ronen en el Distrito 9, que incluye la misión. Ella se siente increíblemente triste y se disculpa porque no puede estar aquí el día de hoy, en este día tan importante y especialmente con esta acción tan poderosa de la comunidad. Ella tiene a su papá enfermo ahorita y tuvo que volar a Los Ángeles hoy para cuidarlo. Ella definitivamente estuviera aquí si no fuese por esa situación. La supervisora quería que yo expresara nuestro deseo acerca de la real responsabilidad de los hechos que tiene que ser tomada por las instituciones y la verdadera justicia que se merecen Luis Góngora y su familia. Nosotros creemos firmemente que se necesitan investigaciones rápidas y decisiones rápidas para que pueda haber ambas justicia y resolución para las familias. Es verdaderamente indignante que las familias tengan que esperar años para que estos casos se resuelvan. Y nunca puede ser este el caso. La familia está sufriendo tan intensamente. Entonces, cuando estas decisiones toman tantos años, ya no podemos llamar que eso es justicia. Nuestra oficina está tomando acción para poder resolver esta crisis de personas sin hogar que tenemos en la ciudad y sobre todo en la misión. Y nuestro enfoque es prevenir que esto vuelva a ocurrir. Estamos creando nuevos espacios para que la gente pueda ir, para asegurarnos que las personas pobres, que las personas sin hogar, sean tratadas con dignidad y humanidad. Estamos empujando para que abran más centros de navegación y más unidades de hogares que sean asequibles para la comunidad. Estamos también buscando una verdadera responsabilidad de los hechos de parte del Departamento de Policía. Necesitamos reformas que sean sistémicas acerca de cómo usan la fuerza. Y tenemos también que entonces estar vigilantes muy cercanamente del Departamento de Policía durante este proceso de reformas. Tenemos, por ejemplo, una reunión que viene en la Junta de Supervisores el 2 de mayo a las 2 de la tarde, donde el jefe de policía tiene que reportar avances en la implementación de las recomendaciones del panel del Blue Ribbon, no me acuerdo cómo se dice Ribbon. Y
del cordón azul
y el reporte del Departamento de Justicia acerca de San Francisco específicamente. Esperamos que puedan venir todos ustedes de nuevo el 2 de mayo a ser parte de esta reunión y ayudarnos a asegurar de que hay responsabilidad por parte del Departamento de Policía. Muchas gracias. I'm gonna try to be a little briefer in English. Sí se puede. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Carolina Morales, and I am here representing Supervisor Hillary Ronen of District 9, which includes the mission. She's incredibly sorry that she cannot be here today in this very important date during this very powerful action. Her father is ill, and she had to fly to Los Angeles to care for him. She would definitely be here if this was not the case. Supervisor Ronen wants me to express our desire for real accountability and justice for Luis Góngora and his family. We strongly believe we need rapid investigations and rapid decisions so there can be both justice and resolution for the families. It is outrageous that families have to wait for years on end on resolutions on these cases. This should never be the case. The family is suffering already so intensely. So when decisions take so many years, we cannot call it justice. Our office is taking action to address the homeless crisis in the mission and trying to make a dent in San Francisco. Our focus is to prevent this from happening again. We're creating places for people to go to ensure we're treating homeless folks and poor folks with humanity, with dignity. We're both pushing for more navigation centers and more affordable housing units. We also are seeking greater accountability from the police department. We believe we need systemic reforms around use of force. Our office will be watching closely the police department during this reform process. We have, for example, another committee of the whole coming up during our board meeting on May 2nd at 2 p.m., where the chief will be reporting updates on his movements towards implementing the recommendations by the Blue Ribbon Panel and the Department of Justice report to San Francisco. We would love to see all of you again during this meeting on May 2nd at 2 p.m. so that we can ensure that the community is holding all of us accountable. Thank you so much.
Again, calling out another young person from Decolonize Academy. He's got his sign, Stop Killing Our Kids. Yes! Amin Ra, Tivu, Amir, Zahir. You can hold it up, hon. I do want to also just again, Luis Presente! We're talking about honoring our ancestors, and I want again, the First Peoples, our Ohlone ancestors who are still with us, as we heard from Karina, who started us out today. But the reason I bring that up is because this kind of violent gentrification that we're experiencing now that led to, in many ways, the death of our brother Luis Dimitri Gungarapat, also led to the death of Iris Canada, led to the death of Ron Lickers and Elaine Turner and so many more, that these things are all connected. We can't talk about polarized terror. We can't talk about the death of Luis without talking about the death of Iris. We can't talk about the death of our young people without talking about the death of young people across these false borders. So again, relating this to what they call intersectionality, but really it means as poor people, as an indigenous people, as decolonizers, as black and brown people, we are all connected. And it is so important for us to be here today. So thank you. Justice for Luis.
Justice for Luis.
And with that, we're going to call a powerful poet up who's going to carry us through. Oh, sorry. Which one? Oh, sorry. Francisco Ugarte, who's going to actually talk about our migrante peoples and the struggles across these false borders and the way that was related, of course, to Luis.